this little ball of thread up here up the front. I'm using some orange thread. I'm going to use orange, yellow, and black, kind of the colors like it was a golden stonefly. First thing we want to do is put a couple tentacles up front. I'm going to cut a little set of black tentacles and fold them over. Fold them over in my hand and then stick them up here. Try to capture them. Get them situated the way I want them. Squeeze them down too tight. Pretty good. Come back here to the back a little bit. Now we take a piece of foam. I'm going to use yellow for the belly. So I'm going to take a little piece of yellow foam, stick it on the hook, and wrap it down. I like to take it all the way back to where the hook starts to curve a little bit. It helps keep the fly floating more evenly. Otherwise, the back tends to droop. Now I'm going to cut me some little piece of black rubber legs for the tentacles that come out of the back of the egg sac. Situated about like I want them. That's good enough. And then go ahead and wrap them on down. Next thing I want is the furled body. It has to come off of here. So here we have a package of black Antron yarn. Cut a little piece of this, and then I'll cut a little piece of orange Antron yarn, about the same length, and a little piece of yellow or green. And let's grab this yellow, cut it. Now we take these three pieces of yarn. I wet the end of them so they're a little easier to deal with. And I grab them with some alligator clips. If you got something better than alligator clips, that wouldn't be a bad thing, because alligator clips, they tend to come loose sometimes, but you do the best you can. And so here we sit there and we start to twirl them together. Twirl, 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 tighter and tighter. We don't need much length. But we tighten it up until it starts to furl. It gets kind of tight and small, and it's wanting to furl up on you. When it gets that way, you can grab it, pull it up from the middle. This is hard to see, I know. But if you pull it up the middle and pull the ends together, and what you'll get is you'll get a little furled piece sticking up the top. I let go with the alligator clip and I pull it on out, and now I've got this little furled body. Got this wing material. I'm going to take and cut a piece of it. cut me a strip and I'll trim off what I don't want. So this is called veiny wing material. And you can buy this various places. Sometimes I use this. Sometimes I use deer hair. Take the furled body made out of Antron yarn and wrap it on here. To kind of give it a little wrap here at the end and tie it off. Cut the excess. We got this furled body sticking out. Get us a piece of, in this case, orange. A little strip of orange foam. This piece here is about 1.5 inches long. And I'll have excess. All along the back here. And then I'm going to get piece of this veiny wing material. I cut a strip of that. I want to stick out just a little ways past my body. Tie that on. Fold my head over. Tie it up. Put a knot or two in it. Or three or four. The original fly calls for deer hair to be used for the wings. So I cut off a little bit of this brown deer hair. Here, and then there's an alternative to the lacy wings. Actually, the original fly uses this. Trim that off. I'm gonna get me some legs. These are pumpkin legs. I don't need them too long. Go. Come back here. Stick some on this side. Give them a tug and that makes them stick out. And get me one for the other side. Give it a tug and makes it stick out. Tie it off. Cut the thread. Trim my legs. Trim the back here. Got a little excess there. Trim my wings. Why are they not so square? And there we have a stone file. Take some crazy glue. Once I let that dry, I'm going to treat this furled body with Scotch Guard so that it doesn't absorb water so much and want to droop. Once the glue on the fly has dried, then I like to treat the furled body with some Scotch Guard. So I just take it, spray it down there, dip that yarn in the Scotch Guard real good, right? Get it nice and wet. And then I just take it and stick it on a piece of foam and let it dry. Here's our stone fly.